Hello everyone, myself Mallesh, lecturer, Mechanical Engineering, Department of Collegiate and Technical Education. Today I am going to teach steam boiler unit 2 session 2 in applied thermal engineering for 5th semester mechanical engineering students. Dear students, this is session 2. In previous session I have explained so many things, started from basic definition of boiler, function of boiler, applications of boiler, classification of boiler, selection of a steam boiler, Indian boiler regulations, important terms used in the boilers, so comparison of water tube and fire tube boilers. So those are the concepts I have explained in detail. So today in my session 2, I have took three boilers for explanation. So those are low pressure boilers, simple vertical boiler, construction and working, Cochran boiler, construction and working, advantages and disadvantages. Advantage of Cochran boiler, Babcock and Wilcox boiler, construction and working. Students, let's see what is low pressure boiler. In generally, we have a low pressure and high pressure boiler. So in previous session, I have explained about a classification of boiler. So depends upon the pressure. Also, we can classify as a low pressure boiler as well as a high pressure boiler. So the low pressure boilers are almost fire tube boilers and the high pressure boilers are almost water tube boilers. So let's see what is low pressure boiler and what is high pressure boiler. So what is low pressure boiler? Then low pressure boiler is limited to 15 PSI. That means 15 PSIG the boilers are designed for 15 PSIG capacity, then we can call as a low pressure boiler. So generally it is used for heating applications and as well as domestic application they are going to use. So in a low pressure boiler, the pressure does not exceed 15 PSI and the temperature will not rise above 250 Fahrenheit. So then low pressure steam boilers do not need to be monitored regularly and usually only have to be checked when they begin to break down, because this is very limited application. That's why the breakdown is very limited, and that why regular checkup is not necessary for this type of boiler. We can check in not regularly, we can give occasionally, we can check the performance of the boiler, that is enough for this boiler. So since low pressure steam boilers are typically used to maintain building heat, heating load, and it is an important factor in domestic application. This is the purpose of low pressure boilers. So again, the low pressure steam boilers are often used in buildings and designed to supply heat to individual rooms through the radiators. So in cold countries, this type of boilers are going to use. So because there is a cold conditions, for that purpose to make the hot conditions of the room, this type of boiler will supply the heat to the particular room, then the temperature of the room will be increased. So in another purpose, building heated by low pressure steam boilers may include restaurants, hospitals, office buildings and schools. These boilers can be used to heat the water supplied to bathrooms, and the steam is used to supply heat through the buildings. So you can say, see, these are mainly used for individual rooms through the radiators. Again, the buildings, for pressure used for the restaurants, hospitals, office buildings and schools. Again, this boiler can be used to heat the water supplied to the bathrooms, and the steam is used to supply the heat throughout the buildings. So preferably for large and all, this type of the boiler is mandatory to install, because for limited application this low pressure boilers are going to use. Okay, students, let us see one of the important boiler in our thermal field, that is a simple vertical boiler. Okay, this comes under low pressure boiler, why I explained. So why? Because this is a very low pressure and low pressure boiler, the use for small quantities. So I already explained in previous slide, that is below 15 PSIG pressure, those called as a low pressure boiler. So such a boiler, simple vertical boiler, is also a low pressure boiler, which will also works below 15 PSIG. So again this boiler is say for low pressure and small quantity and used for low power generation at a space is limited. Four points we have to consider here. One is low pressure, one is small quantity, and then is a low power generation or at a space limited. So these are the main criteria for the simple vertical boiler. So this boiler consists of a cylindrical shell surrounded by a cylindrical firebox. So let us move on next slide. We'll explain detailly. So this is cylindrical firebox is slightly tapered towards the top at the hollow top to allow the ready passage of the steam. I will show you in the diagram. So this is a diagram of a simple vertical boiler. Okay, before going to this, you watch this video, you can clearly understand how the simple vertical boiler shows. Students, let's see here. This is the animation of a simple vertical boiler. So here you have a cylindrical shell. You can call this a cylindrical shell. Again, you have a fire grate is there, and we have a crash tubes, and we have a chimney, straight tubes, we have a safety valve here, steam stop valve is there, a pressure gauge is here, and then we have a water is surrounded by this is fire tube. You can generally this is a fire tube boiler. Here the combustion, due to combustion, the flue gas flows upward due to motion of the flue gas, the heat is transferred to the surrounding water. So then water is get heated and stored in the steam space. So this is the animation of a simple vertical boiler. It will give the clear picture about simple vertical boiler. You just observe this animation. So here the grate, upon grate some coal is fed, the coal will get burned in the combustion chamber. This also be in cylindrical shape. This is the hash pit. We can call hash pit to collect burnt after combustion. The output of hash will be collected here. Again we have a cylindrical shell, and we have a HN. We can call as a that is a this is the hand holes are given in both side. In both side we have a manhole also here to cleaning purpose. We have a chimney, and we have a safety valve, pressure gauge, and we have a water level gauge is also there. So this diagram clearly shows how the steam boiler will operate. Let's see how it is works. So already I have explained this one. I have a cylindrical shell I have shown, and the cylindrical firebox also I have shown. It's a tapered position I have shown. So next I shown grate also. The grate is here. In this portion, this is a grate. You can call this as a grate upon which the coal is fed. An uptake tube passes from the top of the firebox to the chimney. So this is the uptake tube. You can call this is uptake tube. So it will connected to cylindrical box as well as the chimney. That is called as a uptake tube passes. A manhole is given. This is a manhole is given for the cleaning purpose to enter the shell boiler shell to cleaning purpose as well as infections also. So this is the simple vertical boiler. So how it is working? The fuel burns on the grate. The fuel fed on the grate. The fuel will burns on the grate in the firebox. The resulting hot flue gases by the burning are allowed to pass around the crash tubes. So when the fuel burns on the grate in the firebox, again it flows upwards direction. It will allow to pass around the crash tubes. The water surrounding the cylindrical firebox also receives heat by convection and radiation. So here the heat transfer method is convection and radiation. Thus the steam is produced. For that purpose the steam will get produced. The water circulation in the boiler depends on the density difference in the water. So how the water circulation will occur? Due to density difference in the water created by temperature difference in the water. So due to heat transfer rate occurred in the fire tube as well as water, the amount of water circulated to the amount of water will get converted into steam, and it will flows upward direction and stored in the cylindrical shell. So that's the thing. So here we have to keep in point. So the circulation will be natural circulation. Due to density difference, the water will flows upward. So these are the simple vertical boiler. Let's move on to the Cochran boiler. So before explaining Cochran boiler, just view on how Cochran boiler will work. just a glance. I will show you one small video for the how the Cochran boiler will works. Then I will explain in detail.
Now we shall see the working of the Cochran boiler. Coal is fed into the grate through the fire hole and burnt. Ash formed during burning is collected in the ash pit provided just below the grate, and then it is removed manually. The hot gases from the grate pass through the flue pipe to the combustion chamber. The hot gases from the combustion chamber flow through the horizontal fire tubes and transfer the heat to the water by convection. The flue gases coming out of the fire tubes pass through the smoke box and are exhausted to the atmosphere through the chimney. Smoke box is provided with a door for cleaning the fire tubes and smoke box. There are various mountings fitted to the boiler. The first one is a pressure gauge. This indicates the pressure of the steam inside the boiler. There are normally two water gauges fitted over each boiler. The water gauge indicates the level of water in the boiler. The water level in the boiler should not fall below a particular level. Otherwise, the boiler will be overheated and the tubes may burnt out. Next is the safety valve. The function of the safety valve is to prevent an increase of steam pressure in the boiler above its normal working pressure. The next mounting is the steam stop valve. It regulates the flow of steam supply to the requirements. Two of cock. It is located at the bottom of the boiler. When the blow-off cock is opened during the running of the boiler, the high pressure steam pushes or drains out the impurities like mud, sand, etc. in the water collected at the bottom. Fusible plug. It protects the fire tubes from burning when the water level in the boiler falls abnormally low.
Students, let's see here. The video clearly shows how the Cochran boiler will work. So here, as explained by the video, we have a fire hole, we have a grate, and then we have a shell, cylindrical shell, hemispherical shape. This hemispherical shape. So from we have a blow off cock. I will explain in detail. This is a flue tube connected to the fire tube. Here this is a fire tube. So here I have a fusible plug. This is surrounded by the water. So the once the things is, we'll say here from the combustion, the generated flue gases flows to the flue pipe to the combustion chamber. The combustion chambers are lined together with the fire brick linings to resist the outflow of the temperature to surrounding, and again it flows to the tube, horizontal fire tube. So again it will flows from to the smoke box to the chimney. So due to this, the water surrounded by the tube, the heat will transfer to the surrounded water. Then the water will get converted into steam and will stored in this portion. So here this boiler will contain number of accessories. So those are steam stop valve, safety valve, pressure gauge, and we have a blow off cock and fusible plug. So already explained, the blow off cock is to shut off the flame when the temperature is reached the maximum level. This is the blow off cock function. And the blow off cock is to remove the excess pressure or water pressure, or to sorry, suppose it will contain some moisture content in the shell that will remove from the blow off cock. So again we have fusible plug is to shut off the furnace due to unburnt explosion. Again we have a water gauge is to indicate water level in the steam drum, as well as we have a manhole provided for the inspection as well as a cleaning purpose, pressure gauge to monitor the pressure continuously, and we have a safety valve to safeguard the boiler from the excess pressure. Again we have steam stop valve is the device used to control or shut off our flow to the steam from in and out, out of the steam boiler. So these are the main accessories are mounted on the Cochran boiler. So let's see what are the main parts having this Cochran boiler. So the Cochran boiler is a vertical multi-tubular and for small capacity steam generations are going to use. So already you see this is a multi-tubular, this is the number of tubes are there, and it is a vertical multi-tubular. This is the vertical position boiler commonly used for small capacity steam generation. Again it is made in different sizes for evaporative capacities ranging from 150 to 3000 kg per hour and working pressure up to 15 bar. So up to 15 bar already I explained. So low pressure boilers are always below the 15 bar. So these boilers also comes under low pressure boiler, that is below 15 bar pressure. So this is the typical diagram of Cochran boiler. In your examination you need to write this type of diagrams. So see, from harsh pit we have a grate and we have a fire box. So from fire hole, the coal will fed inside, and the coal will actually burn in the fire grate, on the fire grate, and the output, that is the after burning, the hash is liberated, the hash will be stored here. Again we have a two type hash here, the fly hash as well as a bottom hash. So the bottom hash will be that is a weighted hash, it will be flows down, and the flue gas with fly hash containing with less weight will flows upward through the flue pipe to the combustion chamber. From the combustion chamber it will flows horizontally to the horizontal fire tube, again then to the smoke box. From the four smoke box again it flows to the chimney. So from the chimney where the fly ash will be flows down, and it will be taken out from the smoke box doors. So these are the construction feature of a Cochran boiler. So already shown in the diagram as well as videos also I am explained. So we have a manhole is also there, pressure gauge, safety valve, stop valve, etc. is there. So let's move on. So Cochran boiler is an external cylindrical shell is having, and firebox both are hemispherical. It's a short pipe with a firebox and a combustion chamber is having. This is containing chimney with the gases from the smoke box escape to the atmosphere. The chimney is the device to escape the gases out of the smoke box to the atmosphere. A manhole provided for the cleaning purpose. A grate with a coal is fed through the firewall. A grate is a platform is given for the combustion purpose. So these are the main components of Cochran boiler, as well as the construction detail of a Cochran boiler. Let's see a working principle, how it is works. So the hose form, so I already told, from the fire hole the coal is fed onto the grate. In the grate the fuel will burn. So after burning the hash is formed, during the burn is collected in the hash pit. The hot gas from the grate passes through the combustion chamber to the horizontal fire tubes. The heat transfer to the water by convection. Here the method of heat transfer is convection methods. The flue gases passes through the smoke box and escape to the atmosphere through the chimney. Smoke box is provided with a door for cleaning purpose. The working pressure and the steam capacity is 6.5 bar and 3500 kg per hour respectively. So this is how the actual Cochran boiler will work. So let's see the advantages of a Cochran boiler. So this is a low initial investment. So as of now, this is a low pressure boiler. The pressure ranges is very limited, that is below 15 psi. For that purpose the investment is required less. It required less floor area. Although this is a vertical boiler, but for that purpose we can use, this is a less floor area is sufficient to install. Easy to operate and handle. So easily anyone easily can handle and easily can operate. So that is a one main advantages. Transportation of the Cochran boiler is very easiest. It can use all type of fuels. So in this boiler we can use solid or gaseous or liquid fuels. So these are the main advantages of a Cochran boiler. Move on to disadvantages of a Cochran boiler. Students, so for any advantages there may be disadvantages. Let's see what are those. The low rate of steam generation. So although this is a 5-tube boiler, so in 5-tube boiler the the application of heat transfer is very limited from the 5-tube to external water. For that purpose the generation of steam generation is very limited, so that is called it's a low rate of steam generation. Inspection and maintenance are difficult. So the inspection and maintenance are very difficult because these are 5-tube boiler. The n number of fire, the n number, the all the parts are facing the heating purpose. Say the all the exposes to heating. So all the parts, maximum 70% of the parts are exposed to heating. For that purpose, it will be very very difficult to inspect and maintain. This is a difficult. High room head is required for installation due to its vertical design. So high room head, because it's a vertical design, so required high room head for the installation purpose. So to withstand all the shock and vibrations etc. for the purpose, for mechanical reason should require high room head, and it is a limited pressure range. As I said this is a low pressure boiler. For that purpose it is a limited pressure, it will be very limited. So these are the disadvantages of a Cochran boiler. So dear students, next move on the Babcock and Wilcox boiler. I have explained a simple vertical boiler as well as Cochran boiler. Those are 5-tube boilers. So now move into the water tube boilers, that is the Babcock and Wilcox boiler. Before getting to the actual Babcock and Wilcox boiler, let's see glance and about a small video I have given to you to watch. Please just watch.
Babcock and Wilcox boiler. Let's try to understand its construction and working. It consists of a straight horizontal longitudinal drum filled with water. The boiler drum is connected with a series of uptake header tubes at the front end and downtake header tubes at the rear end. These tubes are connected by a series of inclined water tubes. Generally, the water tubes are having inclination of about 15 degrees. The solid fuel is fed through the fire door and then burnt over the grate to produce hot flue gases. These flue gases are then forced to move upwards between the water tubes, where baffle plates are provided to guide the movement of flue gases and ensure proper heating of the water tubes. On absorbing heat, the water flowing in the water tubes gets converted into steam. This steam moves towards the uptake header and gets collected over the water level in the boiler drum. Here, anti-priming pipe is provided to separate water from the steam, and dry steam is then supplied to the superheater tubes. This converts the saturated steam into superheated steam, which can be taken out from the steam stop valve. Ash produced by the burning of fuel is collected in the ash pit, while the smoke is allowed to escape into the atmosphere through a chimney. A damper is installed before the chimney to regulate the air supply into the firebox. The boiler operation is inspected through the inspection doors on a regular basis. Boiler assembly is suspended on steel girders to enable the boiler drum and water tubes to expand and contract during operation. The boiler is fitted with other usual mountings like pressure gauge, water level gauge, feed check valve, safety valve, blow off valve, etc. This is the complete construction and working of straight horizontal Babcock and Wilcox boiler.
Students, All are watched this video. The that is explained detailedly how the Babcock and Wilcox boilers are working. So let's see how the Babcock and the Wilcox boiler are working and the use for which purpose. So let's see. This is a first water tube boiler designed widely used. So it's a stationary water tube boiler. And it consists of a steam water drum. So I will explain you in detail in the next diagrams. So let's see. This is the water tube boiler designed for widely use. It's a stationary water tube boiler and it consists of a steam water drum. A short tube connects the steam water drum with uptake header and downtake header. So I will show you in the next slides. The mud box is provided for down space header and mud collected. And it is removed. A mud box is collected for the removal of the mud. Again, there is a slow moving automatic chain on which the coal is fed. So here chain grade systems are used to supply the coal to the from the hopper to the grate. So this is the fire the Babcock and Wilcox boiler. Here you have a fire bricks baffle plates also there that deflects the hot gases and helps the hot gases to leave the chimney. So I will show you. The dampers are also used to draw and are operated by the chain and a pulley. So let's see, this is the color visions of a Babcock & Wilcox diagram. I already shown this is the inclined water tubes. So here have a cylindrical shell to store water as well as the steam. So here we have a blue color contains the water, and we have a this color contains steam purpose. So here this is the flue gas is yellow color. So here this is a grate. So from this is a chain grate, we can call it a chain grate. From the chain grate, the combustion will occur here. So after combustion, the whatever the ash will generate will flows down here. So again, the flow of flue gases will take this direction. We can call this a zigzag direction. So this is a zigzag direction. So when the flue gas passes around the water tube, then the heat contained the flue gases will transfer to the water contained the tube. Then the water in the tube will get heated. So due to density difference, the water flows upwards to the uptake header. So initially the feed wall is given here. From the feed wall, the water will flows to the drum. You can call it a boiler drum. From the drum, due to the gravity, the downtake header will take the water from the drum again. Then the water will circulate in the tube, inclined tube. Then due to heat transfer rate, the density will be increases. And due to density difference, the water will flow upward again and will stored in the uptake header and be stored in the drum. So afterwards, the flue gas will flow around zigzag way and again passes through the damper. This is a damper is provided to allow the flue gases to the out of the through chimney to the atmosphere. So for the purpose, damper is provided, and we have a mud box is also provided to remove the mud contained in the boiler device. Again, we have a various mountings also there, pressure gauge, and we have a safety valve. Let's move on to next slide. We'll explain detailly. So this is the typical diagram of a Babcock & Wilcox boiler. I already explained. So this is the chain grate stroker. The chain grate stroker will supply the fuel from the hopper to the grate. You can say this is a combustion chamber. From this combustion chamber, the flue gases will flow zigzagly and it will flow out the damper to the chimney. Again, we have a downtake header. This is a downtake header and this is uptake header. So this is called downtake header and this is the uptake header. So here we have a steam drum. This is steam drum, steam and water contained here. So the feed wall is there. Water is fed to the steam drum by the feed pump. So here water will due to gravity flows down by the downtake header. From the downtake header, it will flows to the inside the tube. The tube contained the water will get heated by transferring of the heat from the flue gases. Again, it flows to the uptake header and I can stored in this free space. So these steams are a saturated steam. These saturated steams are taken away from this valve to the super heater. This is a super heater there by the application of heat. With application of heat, the steam pressure will be remain constant, but the temperature will increase. So due to temperature increase, the steam will steam will converted into saturated steam to superheated steam. Again, it will taken out to the stop valve. So from there you can use for the external purpose. So this is how the Babcock and Wilcox boiler work. So here how we have some mountings are there for the safe working of the boilers. Those are safety valve, stop valve, and we have pressure gauge and water level gauge, and these have the feed valve is also there. So these are all these safety devices, or these are all the mountings are mounted on the Babcock and Wilcox boilers to safe operations of this boiler. So here you have mud box to collect the mud stored in the boiler, and then we collected out, and we have a hash pits also there here. So the collected hash is also down, taken out with the hash pit. So these are the damper is provided for the outlet for the chimney to the atmosphere. So this is the Babcock and Wilcox boiler. So working principle I'll explain in detail. So coal is fed to the grate through the fire door, and it is burned. The baffles deflected the flue gases, and these flue gases travel in a zigzag manner up over the water tube and superheater. The flue gases escape to the atmosphere through the chimney. I already explained. There is a damper is provided. Water rises into the drum through the uptake header. The steam and the water are separated in the drum, and the steam collected in the upper part of the drum. I already shown in the diagram. So again, the water from the drum comes down through the down header into the water tubes. Though the circulation is called as an active circulation is maintained. So what are the main features we can see? So the Babcock and Wilcox boiler having a operating capacity is quite high, as a 20,000 to 40,000 kg per hour. The operating pressure lies between 11.5 bar to 17.5 bar, because I already say this is a little bit high pressure boiler, and this is a draught losses are very minimum. The defective tubes can be replaced easily. This is the water tube boiler. Here the defect in the tubes are occurring more, because the tubes are exposed to flue gases temperature. For that purpose, the bursting chances are more in this water tube boiler. For that purpose, we can say this defective tubes can be replaced easily. We can easily replace due to construction. We can see in the construction it is a very huge space required to separate the tubes. Also, the entire boiler is an iron structure. Already previous diagram I shown. These are the iron structures. Iron structures are there to given holding the boiler. So this is about Babcock and Wilcox boiler. Students, we have learned today with a low pressure boiler. Those are simple vertical boiler, Cochran boiler, and we have a little bit high pressure boiler. We can say high pressure boiler, water tube boiler. That is Babcock and Wilcox boiler. We have seen lot of advantages, special features. So students, I have taken some MCQs about this session. So those are the water tubes in the simple vertical boilers are vertical, either horizontal or inclined. The answer is inclined. It's a platform. The combustion chamber upon which the fuel is burnt is called either is a furnace, grate, or boiler shell. The answer is grate. Again, the rate of generation of the steam is high in water tube or fire tube boiler. The steam generation is high in water tube boiler. For that purpose, I given the answer from water tube boiler. So I have taken three questions, multiple questions in this regards. I have detailly attached the MCQs in. You will get the detailed MCQs in separate way. Here I have shown some of limited MCQs. So this is the activities for you students to prepare a detailed report containing. You have to visit your nearest sugar factory or dairy or any steam power plant and prepare a handwritten note or report on specification of boilers. What are the boilers are applying there? What are the boilers are using there? What are the specifications that boilers contains? Whether it is a steam water tube boiler or a fire tube boiler? What is the pressure? What is the temperature? So what are the mountings are there? Mountings and accessories are mounted on. Accessories are used there. So on their functions, and what are the safety measures are observed? So, okay, these are all the points you should note it and prepare a small report. Report while visiting the sugar factory or dairy or steam power plant. So you have to visit nearest nearest industry or nearest factory, nearest dairy, anything where the boilers are used. You will get more knowledge about what are the boil and live operations of boiler. You can view there. For that, you will have a huge knowledge. You will get huge knowledge from that visit. So please prepare a hand written report and submit it to the concerned staff. So students, I have referred, these are the books, that is Thermal Engineering by R.S. Kurmi and J.K. Gupta, Thermal Engineering by P.L. Balani, Kanna Publications, Thermal Engineering by R.K. Rajput and Practical Thermodynamics, G.D. Rai, Kanna Publications and Thermal Engineering, Mayesh M. Rathore, McGraw-Hill Publications and Basics and Applied Thermodynamics, P.K. Nag. So these are the reference books I have referred. Please go through these books and you will study once and you will know, you know in detail. As you get any doubts, you have to refer those are books, as well as you just mail me to malayshanaik@gmail.com for any questions. So these are all from this session 2. We'll meet you again in session 3. Thank you. Stay safe. Stay home.